accused terrorist Luis Posada Carillas, sorry, I don't know the exact pronunciation. He is a guy who blew up a plane back in the 1970s. Yeah, he's Cuban terrorist against Castro's government. So guess what we're about to do?
Send him to the Supermax facility where he spends all day alone and gets to walk by himself outside for an hour but doesn't speak to anyone else.
Well, since he's accused of being a terrorist, that seems like a pretty good guess, Ben.
He's not accused of being a terrorist. He is a terrorist. He blew up a plane.
That's what a lot of people say. Now, we haven't convicted him of that. We haven't even indicted him of that, but we were going to find out why in a second. But we're not sending him to Supermax, Ben. We're thinking of letting him go. Shocking. We're about to release him on bond because he's on our side. And the thing is he really? Are we that sick? Like that we think that a guy who blows up a plane just because he's against Castro is on our side? I mean, there were civilians on that plane. The Venezuelan government wants him. They want to put this guy away. And we haven't even arrested him on terrorism charges. Instead, we've arrested him on immigration violations. And then, by the way, what happened? I thought we hated illegal immigrants too. But now we're going to release this guy, even though he's an accused terrorist, and he's clearly violated some immigration laws. Why? Because he's against Castro. I mean, the hypocrisy is so gigantic. I don't know, A, how people can stand it, and B, honestly, why does it make, like, giant headlines? Washington Post, New York Times, etc., you know, accused terrorists about to be released. But instead it gets buried in the back of the paper because the power structure says, we're not going to talk about that one because that doesn't show us in a good light.
Yeah, no.
It's sick.
I listened to a story on NPR about some kid who was an exchange student from Cuba, was coming over to study in the West, and he was going to take, like, music lessons. He was going to go to Stanford. I'm making some of this up. But, you know, I mean, that's the kind of people who were on this plane who are now dead. And he masterminded it, according to us, according to everyone.
Yeah, our own government says he did, and still we're about to release him on bond and basically let him go. It's just, look, when you remember that John Walker Lynn, for example, the guy we were just talking about, never actually fought against the United States, you know, Jose Padilla, and now the charges are that he once talked to somebody who might have raised money for the Chechens or the Bosnians. I mean, come on, and that guy was an enemy of the state? That guy was an enemy combatant, stripped of all of his constitutional rights? That guy had to sit in a 9-foot by 7-foot cell for, you know, 3-4 years in a row without seeing his attorney? But this guy who blew up a plane gets to walk away? Look, you know, so when people get frustrated, when the powerless speak out, how do you not blame them? You can't blame them. It's God, it's so frustrating.